All right, guys, we're doing a small block Chevy 350 upgrade, ignition and carburetor upgrade on the 68 Super Sport El Camino. It's got the 350 in there. Made a few other videos. One thing I didn't do is actually show you how to wire the thing. We kind of just got into it and put it together, but I wanted to touch up and basically tell you how the thing went. You saw it running, saw all the parts, the unboxing. But anyway, this package is, in case you wanted to get this for yourself, it's a Pro Billet distributor from MSD, 8361, magneto, trigger, vacuum advance. There's the part number. It's got a bunch of cool stuff on it. Do an advance curve kit and everything else. It's got the vacuum advance. This is the MSD PN6425. It's got the rev limiter that's adjustable right here on the little front piece. It's got the 1000, you can do it in the 1000 and the 100. I went with this Taylor Pro Series wire. It's a Pro Series, I guess they're really good, 8mm. They went together pretty nice. Today we're gonna get that 650 or 600 Edelbrock off of there. And we've got this 750 double pumper going on. It's a model 4150 750, dual pumper chromate with electric choke. We've got the Grand Performance stainless dual inlet fuel line. We went through the firing order, we went through a lot of stuff. Basically, I'm gonna put all these things in looms. Yeah, I do have some valve covers and air cleaner that I'll top it off later. This is just kind of all just to see how this was going to run. So we pulled the HEI out. Now that distributor went in just like any other distributor. And my old system used to run off of this red wire, which was the hot wire for the HEI. So I didn't even solder these. Basically, this rev limiter was pretty easy to hook up. It had a couple little rubber mounts on there that are pretty easy to do. You just screw them in, and then I drilled the four holes in the fender well, and there's some little nuts on the backside. Same with the coil. But as for wiring this thing, all I did is basically plug this in, and you've only got so many options. There's a small red wire, and you follow that red wire, and you hook it up to where your old HEI wire used to be, your little one plug wire. That's it. So that's it for the red wire. The gray wire goes to your tachometer. And so I just clipped that in right over there to where my tack is. Pretty simple. So those two wires are taken care of. This white wire is for something else. I was looking in the directions. That's something to do with the dual point distributor or whatever else, but it doesn't apply to this. And then you only have one other thing that comes out of the harness, and they already have clips on them. So there's just an orange one and a black one, and you just plug that into your coil. And basically, the last two wires are these two red and black ones, and the black one goes to the negative on your battery, and the red one goes to the positive. And that entire ignition system is hooked up. Honestly, I thought it was going to be a lot worse. I sat there and thought about it for a really long time, but if you're hesitant about getting one of these systems, just go for it. You'll have the thing installed in probably, like, honestly, less than an hour. I could probably have put it in a different spot, could have put it up on the firewall, could have done a lot of things. The wiring's, you know, sitting around kind of all bunched up and zip tied. It's not looking that great. But as for actually hooking it up, that's how to hook it up. It's just a few wires and you're basically ready to go. This little door pops right off of here. The adjustments can be made while the vehicle's running. I tested it last night and put it at 2000 and gave it some gas, and it was rev limiting at 2000. Then we put it at 55 and went and ran, and it worked great. So basically, if you're looking for a good system for an upgrade, that's the one I went with. And I can't wait to get this carburetor on here, this double pumper, and this thing is going to hit hard. So this is pretty straightforward too. Shouldn't take too long to bolt this up and get this thing going, and then we will do another update after we get this carb on here. All right, we will see you on the next video.